how we run the takedown challenges. For those that take over the website, the last 8 years, Paul and Carolyn, you're not gonna know who these people are, but Paul and Carolyn Fetter have been a friend of mine. They own two personal training studios in Huntington Beach, California. They've been running this program for the past 8 years. I met Paul 6 or 7 years at a personal trainer's business owners conference, and we went to the same conference 4 or 5 years in a row, got to know each other, and he started talking about this program that his wife had created. Sell this thing to like studio, like places like Mito, like because it's awesome. He's telling me about these results on my con. There's no way you're seeing those kinds of results. So I wasn't told that. I encourage him to do that. Eventually, this past in the winter, actually, he started. I picked it up in the spring. They started promoting it to a short group, a small group of studio owners that they felt could do a good job with it. And this fall, they're actually launching it across the U.S. So we'll see, again, two personal training studio owners. So it's still very small. We're the only one in Canada that offers it. It's an awesome program. It really, we ran it for the first time in the spring, and quite honestly, it did everything we wanted it to. Everything they had said it was, everything I thought it was going to be, it did all of that. So I want you to ask questions if you have any, but I'm going to try and keep it really simple because there's a lot of information that we're going to give you, and Mark and I are available pretty much 24/7 over the next 4 weeks for anything that you need by email, in person, over the phone, whatever that is. We are here to support you 100% because, as you can imagine, it's in our best interest that you all see great results. So we want you to because we like this, but also because we want you to see good results because it's good for the program. People talk about it. A lot of people heard about it in the spring and are jumping on board this time around. Okay? So for those of you who don't know me, I'm Mike Bates. I'm from my fitness studio. And this is Marco. We'll be jumping in throughout. Marco's our head trainer here. Marco oversees our whole training department, which is eight trainers, and really oversees just basically the quality of our programming to make sure our clients are seeing results. At the end of the day, not in charge of how much we sell, not in charge of how much we market, but making sure our clients are seeing results. There's not a lot of places that have someone that just looks after that kind of stuff. So it's really important.
Thanks.
He does a great job. Grab the pink page. When we did this in the spring, Carolyn said, make sure you color code the pages. And I said, not worthwhile. Well, the first time we did this, I said, look at the page and grab it. It makes sense to do this. There's a reason why I did color code it. Okay? So, challenge rules. Part of the program is we're guaranteeing you're going to lose 12 to 24 pounds in the next 28 days. In order for that to happen, you can't just show up. You have to actually do some work to get there. Okay? So, the rules. And we're going to touch base on all these throughout while we're talking. Okay? So, every Tuesday, starting a week from Tuesday, not this first Tuesday, the program starts on Tuesday. Someone in this room is going to show up on Tuesday with a blank food drawn on the weigh-in. It's okay, but you don't need to do that. The second Tuesday is going to be your first weigh-in, right? We will have done all your measurements, almost all of you, today. Your first weigh-in will be a week from Tuesday, which is September the 17th. Okay? The program starts on Tuesday. If you show up, you're not going to make your food drawn. You haven't started the program yet. You can start the program the next couple days if you want to. So you got to bring your food journal to your weigh-ins. It has to be filled out. If you show up for your weigh-in, you don't have your food journal, we'll weigh in, we'll say thank you, we'll answer any questions you've got. You're not going to get your menu. You're not going to get your menus for that. You have to have your food journal with you filled out. So, okay? Food journaling is a core part of any really good health and fitness program. We believe in it for a long time, and it just flat out works. Sometimes it's a pain in the butt, absolutely. But everybody that goes back to it normally kind of shakes their head, I know. Should have done it, but once they're ready in their head and they start food journaling, amazing things start to happen. So we're starting out from day one telling you, you got food journal. It's that simple. It's the only way we can give you feedback. If you're telling us, well, I had this deed, I did this, we can't evaluate that for one. And I can tell you right now, you're exaggerating probably just about everything. We know the science is really clear. People always underestimate the calories that they take in, and they always overestimate the amount of exercise. Always. Almost every single study on that confirms that, so you gotta write that. Okay? So that's gonna be on Tuesdays.
Also, we found that, especially in the first week last time, that even though we're doing this orientation, there's a lot of information. It's very easy to get confused. Maybe sometimes if you're doing a certain recipe, there were a few people that would eat a whole recipe and it was supposed to be four portions. We would never see that unless you wrote it down. So that really helps us to nip anything in the bud that we see right away that may be incorrect with the recipe. So super important for that.
The weigh-ins on Tuesdays, anytime between 6 a.m. and 9:30. Occasionally, if you're really late, Sarah works, our student manager works on Tuesday nights. if there's no one in here at 9 o'clock, technically we'll close the doors. So just try and, I'd say get in here before 9 o'clock. Sometimes we don't have anybody in here at 9, just after 9 o'clock. So anytime between 6 a.m. and 9 p.m, you'll ask for Mark or I. If one of us isn't available, the girls at the front desk are gonna weigh in. They're gonna write your weight down. And if you've got any concerns about anything whatsoever, you can mention it to the girls and we'll follow up. It's that simple, okay? Second thing, each challenger must do the prescribed cardio and strength training. It's a humongous part of the program. Everybody on the program needs to do 3 strength training sessions per week and 3 cardio sessions. Total of 1 hour of exercise, 3 days per week for a total of 3 hours of exercise. The strength training and the cardio are critical parts of the component. If you don't do that, you will not see the same results. And equally as bad, you're actually going to lose muscle, which is the opposite of what we want to happen. You need to do the strength training. So we're going to help you with that. If you need help, we'll talk to you about the, kind of some different options there. If you're already exercising with us, you're going to continue on the program. If you're exercising someplace else, we want to know what you're doing. Just give it a blessing. If you need some help with what you're going to do, then most of you at the measurements or after tonight, we'll talk to you about some options if you want to do your workouts here. What we know, hands down, from the last time, is that the people that did the majority of their stuff with us, meaning they were in our environment with our support and our coaching, saw the best results. It's just that simple. It doesn't mean if you're going to do it in your own place at home or your own gym that you're not going to see results. I'm not saying that. But the people who were here the most saw the best results. It's that simple. And you can speculate as to why that might be. It's not that we were helped. It's not that we wanted them to see more results. They're just in this environment. So we're there all the time. Things are scheduled. We can give them feedback on things, and they're more disciplined. It's, I'll go in and work out whenever. Sometimes that doesn't happen, okay? So that's the exercise portion of it, okay? Total of 1 hour, 3 days per week. Questions about that? No problem. You can do 6 half-hour sessions if you want to. Yeah, no problem. They don't have to be all in one day. No problem with that.
Yeah. Yeah, so let's say you come in for an hour, half of that would be cardio, half that would be some form of resistance or weight training. If you decided you wanted to come in Monday, Wednesday, Friday for half an hour to do weights, and then Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday for half an hour to do cardio, you can do that too. Break it up however you want. Because in the end, you're looking at about an hour and a half total of weightlifting, and an hour or time to train, or an hour and a half total of cardio. How you divide it up and mix it up is really up to you as long as that work gets done.
Oh, absolutely. We're fully in favor of you doing more.
Yeah.
What's that time in conversation about someone doing too much?
Yeah, all the time. I have to totally keep you.
No problem with you doing more. It's just,
yes.
Go for it. Absolutely. So number 4. Anything else? Any other questions? If we haven't done your measurements yet, we'll talk to you about that when we meet with you afterwards. Yep, we'll touch on that. Yep. So number 4. Each challenger must come to all the weekly weigh-ins. Meeting with your consultant is very important. If you skip a week, you will not be allowed to win the following week's weigh-ins. Pretty straightforward. Each week, we're going to be giving out prizes for the person that lost the highest percentage of their body weight. And it's all based on percentage of your body. Everyone's starting at different weights, so that's important. Each person agrees to not use any stimulants, diuretics, or anything like that to enhance your weight loss, which would be cheating, unfair, and all that unhealthy. We don't promote that. It's not something we believe in. You absolutely do not need to use anything else to help you lose weight on this program. It's just not necessary, period, okay? Each challenger must eat the 4 designated meals and agree not to eat less in order to get better results. I mean, you're not gonna see better results by eating less, period. There's no exception to that rule. We've got 2 problems with people that are trying to lose weight. Too much food or eating is just too erratic. When your body doesn't know when you're eating, it doesn't perform optimally. It doesn't burn calories the way it should. It doesn't burn fat the way it should. It starts to conserve energy, slows your metabolism down, and at the end of the day, it just messes up your system. This program is going to have you eating 4 meals, 3 meals and a snack, if you want to call it that, approximately 4 hours apart. When your body gets used to eating like that, amazing things happen. Nobody should be hungry on this program on a regular basis. The first 3 or 4 days, everybody reacts differently. We'll talk about that. But after that, nobody beyond the first 3 or 4 days, and your body's adjusting. Beyond the first 3 or 4 days, we had nobody that was complaining about being hungry on a regular basis. Most people were saying, I'm eating more food than I was eating. Okay? So this is nutrient-dense food. It's going to fill you up, and it tastes really, really good. Any questions about that? Pretty straightforward. Okay? anytime on a Tuesday. So let's look at, let's jump into the menus, the actual recipe books. I'm sorry, Chuck asked about, this is where you're going to write your journals. This is where you're going to write your food journal in, right here. Very simple, one page per day.
We might talk a little bit more about the food journal, but there is a sheet in here that explains what a good food journal looks like. It's not just the food you eat, but I was going to...
Yes,
you're going to cover that.
Absolutely. I'll wait. Yep. So, each Tuesday, assuming you show up your weight and assuming your food journal is filled out, you're going to get a new batch of recipes. These recipes for this fall version of Table Town are totally different than the spring version. I actually didn't know that until about 4 weeks ago, which is awesome. I thought you were going to be eating them. The recipes, these are totally different recipes. Okay, so the books are going to look exactly the same, except there'll be different recipes when you come in. Okay, so by Saturday at the latest, hopefully by tomorrow, you will each get your portions. Okay, we're going to send those out to you. I'm going to show you a sheet in a couple of minutes that will lay out what your portions are. So if you open up, let's go to recipe D.
Look at the bottom. It's
yep, that's the bottom. Recipe D is about 3-4 pages in there. It's everyone's favorite chicken salad. D as in David. Sorry. Everyone got it? Okay. This is my lunch today. I think it's the only thing she repeated in both. It tastes,
it's a popular
one. Awesome. So, most of the recipes in here, you're making them in batches. You're going to get more than that. Which is a great part of the program, so you don't have to think about making a new dinner and a new lunch every single day. Okay? So we're going to assign to you, you're going to get a separate sheet, which I'm going to show you in a minute, that's going to tell you what your portions are going to be. Each recipe has a portion side to it. So on the right hand side, you can see 2-unit portion, 3-unit portion. Okay? So Chuck, let's say Chuck, you're going to be a 4-unit portion. Okay, I'm going to send that to you, I'm going to say, Chuck, your dinners or your lunches, whatever, can be 4 units. You'll know any of the dinners and lunches that you choose can be 4 units. So you'll know you're going to make this whole recipe, but you can only have 1 cup of this. If you're making more than, you're making about 4 cups probably. You can have 1 cup of it, and you can have 1.5 medium apples, sliced or unsliced. That's up to you. Okay? It's up to you. Some of the women, someone who's a little bit shorter, are going to be around 2 or 3 units. Some of the guys who are a little bit bigger, really, height and weight is going to dictate that. Might be up to 5 units. Okay, activity level. There's lots of things that put in that. But we're going to tell you what your units are. So that's critically important. And once you've got that laid out, it doesn't change throughout the program. The menus will change, but you'll know, okay, each day I can have 3 units for breakfast, 3 units for my snack, 4 units for my lunch, and 3 units for dinner, just as an example. That's going to repeat every single day for the next 4 weeks, so you don't have to worry about it. And you're going to have lots of information that's going to have those numbers written on it. Okay, I'm going to show you a sheet that you're going to get now. Okay, so the key, we'll go back to the first page here. You can see the names of all the recipes.
This is like an index of every recipe that's in that book, so it's a really easy, short way to see. You're going to have 4 meals a day. Well, there they are, all listed for you. Okay? The only thing missing information on here is for you is what unit portion you are for each one. So Linda might be a 3 for breakfast, or sorry, a 2 for breakfast, and a 2 for the third meal, right? So when she goes to that recipe, she will go 2-unit portion. What is that? A 2-unit portion of that recipe. And then she might be a 3 for lunch and a 3 for dinner. You could be 3 for all of them. You might be. It really depends on your individual numbers, but you'll know. So basically, that's how that works. So every recipe has 2, 3, 4, or 5 unit portion.
Meal 3 says one choice plus ideas.
Yeah, so ideas, when we get to that, we'll show you, when you go to each page, they'll give you what the other ideas are that can go with that. When you go to those recipes, they have all the things that can come with that. We'll talk about that, so there's 2 things. They'll have them there, Pat, on each page, or there's also a grab-and-go sheet, which are some things that you can add as snacks and things like that. So we'll talk about that when we get to that. So one of the things that Mark and I talked about, you may want to do this, you don't have to do this. Every week we're going to give you a separate sheet with all the recipes listed on it and your unit portion is listed next to them. What wouldn't be a bad idea, it's up to you, you could actually write the unit portions on this front page next to each meal. Also, as a reminder. Okay? Ideally, we would have had that done right now for you, but we just tried to fit too many people in here in the last minute. So we're going to get it to you tomorrow, it won't be a problem. This is what we did in the spring. So, okay?
All the weigh-ins and all the measurements were about, right? Yeah. To get your starting point of B, so we knew what reports to give each of you individually, you're going to get an email that's going to say for each one and how you're going to be received.
And every week you're going to get that. Right. Every week you're going to get the units will not change, it'll just be associated, the rest of these will change. Okay? So keep in mind, most of these recipes, outside of something like the, you know, the banana split smoothie, it's making one smoothie. It's not making 10 smoothies. But a lot of the other things, really your lunches and your dinners, are making three or four portions most of the time. So if you're cooking for your family, there's going to be enough there for your family. Okay, so that's important.
I see, like, whey and soy protein's okay. Can we just use a plant-based protein then?
No problem.
It's not a problem, yep. Just to substitute.
The amount of protein is going to be the amount of protein is going to be the key thing there, and you'll see on the sheet when we get to it. We want to also make sure there's minimum carbs in there.
Okay.
Very, very important. Okay. There's a lot of dynamics with protein powder, which we'll touch on a little bit later.
Okay.
If you can, you want to try and stay with carbs, sweeteners, and things. But at the minimum, the highest amount of protein in your protein powder, the lowest amount of carbs is what you want. We don't want any extra carbs. You want to eat the carbs. Okay. So. Open it up and go to what would be, I guess, the second page. It says week one grocery list. So once you decide which meals look good to you, because some of them you may not want to make. We've got some people that have aspartame allergies, some people are gluten free, we've got a couple of vegans, a couple of vegetarians. You're going to choose which ones work best for you, okay? Based on those, there's a letter associated with each recipe. You're going to go through this grocery list, check and see what you have on hand first. Tick them off, and then you gotta get out and buy some groceries. Okay? And for some people, that's the biggest part of this process is you don't have this good stuff on hand. So when you get home, if you don't have good stuff on hand, you go for convenient crap. That's inevitably what happens, right? Like you gotta get, there's a million things going on, you rush home from work, what are we doing tonight? If you guys say, what are we doing tonight for dinner, that's a problem. That should never happen on this program. Okay? It's gonna be, well, tonight, I know what I'm having. And if you don't know, you're going to open up your book and say, well, I'm going to do this yummy salad with balsamic chicken strips. Or I'm going to do the beef stroganoff. It takes 20 minutes. But you got to make sure you got the stuff on hand, obviously. So you got to go out to the grocery store and get the stuff.
We just have a question. I think maybe some of you are thinking too. Do we have to buy everything on this page? No, you do not have to buy everything on this page. What you're going to do, probably, is look at the front and you're going to be like, oh, what are some of these recipes that sound good to me? I could see myself having the banana split smoothie in the Papa Eggs, but I probably don't really think I want to try that creamy pumpkin oatmeal recipe. So you're going to know ahead of time what recipes you want to try. When you turn to this recipe page, let's use recipe D, the chicken salad that we looked at, as an example. Okay? So if you go down all these ingredients, only the ones that have the D beside them are the ingredients used for that chicken salad. So you only need to buy those. Now, of course, you can demand just chicken salad. There's other meals you got to look at. So when you go grocery shopping, just make sure maybe you have a little sheet that says the letters of the recipe you're going to use. And you're looking here, you can go with your highlight. If I want to make that chicken salad, I got to go down this list and find these almond skinless chicken breasts, highlight. Almond slivers, highlight. Olive oil mayonnaise, highlight. And Caesar's grapes, highlight. So there's certain recipes you may not eat. Well, then you don't need to buy the ingredients for them, obviously. That's why there's a letter beside each of those. Is that relatively clear? Does that answer your question?
Yes.
Okay. In the first week, sorry, go ahead.
In your experience from the grocery store,
remarket the supermarket. I didn't stop it, so I didn't shop it so easy just because there's not one close to me, but you're going to be able to find everything. Remark has everything. Superstore had everything. Those were the two most close to me. I'm assuming Sobeys would have. There's nothing. No. There's only two things on here that are brand names that are from the US. There's an oil and vinaigrette dressing. Just choose a locale oil and vinegar dressing. That's a simple one. And there's a yogurt that she refers to quite a few times in here. We've got a handout here to show you. We've actually printed off the actual nutrition information from the yogurt that she uses. Just find something close to that.
I've even found a couple that are relatively close. If you want to save yourself the work, I'll tell you what they are. You got a question?
Not wrong.
No.
Now, be careful with wanting recipes, people, because these are carefully balanced carbohydrates, fats, and whether you start taking things out, you don't have a full understanding of what was in what you just took out, and you're doing that regularly. Like if you did it for one recipe one time, it wouldn't make a difference. But if you're constantly modifying recipes, you're not gonna
obviously it's going to take us a while. But do you want to just, are you comfortable giving me an example? So some of those things we should talk about, because the main benefit of olive oil, one is the taste, but it's also that's your fat in that particular, in the chicken salad. So we could come up with an example for that, just as, again, we don't want to be doing a lot of this, because you can imagine it's going to fill this way, but you could exchange that with an avocado. The avocado would be a good exchange for the mayonnaise, in that particular example only. I'm not
going to apply that to the healthy fats. You might be thinking, well, why would you use the low fat on the mayonnaise? Because you actually need some more, and especially a healthy olive oil. Makes a difference in the result. Right? That's why I say avocado.
How much of an avocado?
Let's come back to that at the end if you have questions. Okay. Like if you have questions, we'll address that after. Okay. But it would be the same amount of all. I'm saying it would be the same amount that of mayonnaise that was there, like a tablespoon or whatever it says. So much of water. Okay. So the key is that you're looking at the portions. That is absolutely the key. You're making the whole meal, but what applies to you is just the unit portion that's associated with that. You'll know those numbers by tomorrow. And if you have any questions about them, you just need to ask. We expect you're going to have questions about food, so just let us know. Okay? Meals taste great. They really, really do taste good. Your first week of shopping, a few people complain that, oh my gosh, I've never spent so much money on groceries in my life. It's because they weren't shopping. They're eating crap. And you're buying, if you're eating crap, yeah, it's inexpensive. It doesn't cost anything. But a lot of the stuff, you're like, when am I ever going to use this again? Well, you're going to, some of the, trying to think of an example of something on here. Olive oil mayonnaise, just as an example. They're going to require that in other recipes going forward. So there might be some things that you may not have on hand, but she uses them again in other weeks. So just keep that in mind. Like there's a special type of soy sauce and rice wine vinegar. Don't buy huge jars of these things, but you will reuse them in other recipes. And the goal of the program, a lot of people ask, what's the maintenance program after this? You're looking at it. This is the maintenance program. This is the program, and it's the maintenance program. So you should keep making these recipes. You're getting 4 weeks worth of recipes. That easily should be easy. I mean, I work a lot of money. She spent a lot of time on these things. So this is the maintenance program. It's that, and it's really that. That's great for it.
Okay, we touch on that. The two people who applied to me here this month were both in this program, lost a significant amount of weight.
3 months ago,
I've lost that same amount of weight, lost the program again. I continue to work out and use a fair amount of these recipes. Okay.
They've stuck.
Okay.
So that's the pattern.
Just a few things like
bananas,
let's do
it. Sure. Hold on, which one are you on about?
Bananas,
let's
do it. Recipe A.
So, protein powder is something you're probably going to get familiar with. Right? So, a protein powder is basically, you take a food, usually the milk, and you isolate the protein out of that. Your body needs a significant amount of protein. What we find generally, and I'll make this short, people who come to us to lose weight, either they're doing a program like this or any kind of personal training, when we look at their numbers, they're eating nowhere near enough protein and way too many carbs. A protein powder is a very convenient and easy way to up the amount of protein in your diet. That's why it's such a popular supplement. It's a powder. It just comes in with a scoop. You scoop it out, you put it in some water or some milk or some fruit, and you blend it or shake it up, and you drink it. It tastes like chocolate.
We buy it anywhere. We sell it at our front desk.
We sell it at the front desk.
Any grocery store has it, any health food store has it. Yeah. You will not have to isolate the protein from milk. No. Just to be clear, it comes in a packet and ready to go soon. It looks like flour.
Also, flaxseed meal.
Yeah. So flaxseed meal is just ground up flaxseeds. Flaxseeds are these little tiny seeds that are there. Just ground up, get them at the ballpark. They're already
or at the superstore in the organic section. You can find them coconut extracts in the cooking in like the spices area. I just made this the other day. Okay. Individual questions about the recipes. We can address those kind of as we're going along. We can address them easily. Don't feel silly asking, because people will have a lot of questions about that kind of stuff. Please ask. Okay? But we can't go through each individual recipe right now. Okay? So, let's go to. Yeah, that's the one that's more important. Okay, so let's grab the Mac and Go ideas, blue sheet.
When you're ready. And
blue sheet that says pack and go ideas. It's on the right hand side, I think.
Yeah, two sided.
We expect you're going to forget about some of this. We expect you're going to be overwhelmed at certain points. Mark and I will put time aside to talk to you on the phone, email, or meet with you in person. There's no limit to that. How about this? No one's pushed that limit to date. It just hasn't happened. We'll help you with whatever. I don't care if we have to repeat this whole thing for you. We're taping it, so we'll actually send you to the video, and we'll actually meet you in person if you need to. So it's pack and go ideas, okay? If, for whatever reason, the key word here is occasionally, you're not able to make one of the recipes. You're out, you don't have access to a recipe, whatever the reason is, this is what you need to go to, okay? So turn the sheet over. So Mary Ellen, as an example. Okay, so let's say Mary Ellen, most of the women are going to be 2 and 3 unit portions. Most of the guys are going to be 3, 4, probably be 2 and 3. So Mary Ellen, let's say you're 3, 4 lunch. And let's say you're out at a restaurant and you didn't come prepared for whatever reason. But remember that I said this should be in your pocket all the time. Okay? So you pull this out of your pocket. Exaggerating. But it would be good if you had it in your pocket. You know you're a 3 unit portion. What this back sheet tells you, listen very carefully here, if you're a 3 unit, you can choose 3 from each column here. So, as an example, you could have 6 egg whites. If she's a 3 unit portion, she could have 6. She could have a 6-inch banana. And if you choose the peanut butter, she could have a tablespoon and a half of peanut butter. And I'm not saying that's an ideal mixture of food. He's not a chef, people. But that still gives you the idea. You can choose 3 from each column. Okay? If you're a 3, and that would be one of your, whatever 3, if you're a 3-unit portion, whatever that meal is, that would suffice for that. Okay? If you're going for the snacks, a lot of things that she has listed on the snacks, some of them are bars and shakes. But if for a reason you don't want to use those, they are convenient. We don't want you to overdo the bars. You shouldn't have more than one bar and more than one shake per day. Okay? You should be eating real food. One bar and one shake per day are okay. Anything beyond that, you've got to eat real food. You will not see the same results if you go beyond that. You're going to feel hungry. Your body can digest that stuff a lot quicker than it can real food. So that's really important. Okay. So if you're thinking, I want something different for a snack, well, pull something off of here for your snack. If you know your snack late morning or late afternoon, you're a 3-unit portion, go crazy. Maybe you want to have some jerky. It says here you can have 1/2 ounce of jerky. So if you're a 3-unit portion, you can have 1.5 ounces of jerky and pick something else. You could have 12 wheat Ritz crackers and 12 shelled peanuts. If you're a 3-unit portion. If you're 5, then you're going to multiply each one of those by 5.
It's on the
ones that
say both 1 unit protein and carbs, but it does not take something from the carbs as well.
Say that again?
On some of the under protein ideas,
yep.
Does it
account for
both protein and carbs?
2 things. So the ones that have the asterisks next to them, you guys will read some of this, I'm going to bring this up now. It says on the front of this sheet, the ones that have an asterisk, you can only choose 1 unit portion of those. So a whole egg, the cheese, the milk, and the turkey bacon, only 1 of those. The reason that is because of high saturated fat. Everything else, you could do 3 or 4 times depending on your unit portion. Does that answer your question?
No.
Okay.
No, there's a couple here that say 8 ounce.
Oh, yeah.
Both 1 unit protein and carbs.
Yep, so, well, then you can have 3 times that, but that counts. So,
that's both columns.
Correct.
Yes.
Okay. So, a quarter cup of hummus as an example. If you're a 3-unit portion, you're going to have 3/4 of a cup of hummus, but that covers your carbs and your protein. So you're going to have some sort of fat with that, so you could have some peanuts with that. That's what you're going to have, right? If you're choosing that, okay?
Just quickly, just to tie this together, remember on the front of this book, as you go ahead and show this right on your meals, if you look at meal 3, you'll see pack and go option there. That's maybe a more ideal time to have that. I'll tell you, I had an issue with one client last round that was using this all the time. She stopped making these meals and she started going, oh, I can just make my own stuff all the time. And she was always going for crackers and ready carbs because she had a real problem. She wasn't any weight. And as soon as we got her off that and started eating some more vegetables and using the recipes, we saw the results kick back in. So there's probably some of you are going to have a temptation to be like, well, that, I'm just going to always have chicken and right, because it seems simpler. Don't do that. Use those recipes. Okay? One a day. You can see that meal three option. Use it then. Right? That's a good time to use it. Now, you could use it for dinner, like Mike's saying, as a replacement for a dinner meal or something like that, but really do that sparingly. Pardon me. Is that the right word?
Yeah.
Yes. Not a lot. And in addition to these snack ideas, packable ideas, each week, like Marco just said, she's giving you options to choose from. Like she's got this PB&J and original jerky, which is a recipe I should give you that you can choose from as well, like other snack ideas. This is the one, this is the thing that people had the most questions about last time, so, you know, go home, sleep on it, and if you're struggling with it, we can go over it. But this should be used sparingly. And for sure, not every day. We know for sure people that were going to this regularly, and what Marco said about, well, how can I get more crackers? How can I get more bread? They did not see the same results every single time. So anybody that has any concerns or questions that we can't answer, I think we can answer 99% of the questions now, but I'll send a question off to Karen. She's like, wait, I'm doing this. Like, it's this. She's like, right away. She's seeing, she's put over 1,000 views to the program. So we can answer the questions like no problem, okay? But it was people that were trying to make this super convenient and going for the processed stuff or the grainy carbs, they struggled. And we got them out of it, but it's a big change for sure. Okay, everybody okay with that? Okay, Marco, you want to jump into another one?
You might as well do the snack.
Grab and go, sorry. Ready?
Yes.
Okay, so we had a lot of questions regarding protein bars last time. You know, which protein bars are good, which ones should I use? When you're looking for a protein bar, you want one that's higher in protein and a little lower in sugar. Protein bars are at it's not our favorite food to help people eat. I mean, they are very convenient and they can save you sometimes if you really go from eating nothing rather than be a protein bar. But because of the format, it's a bar, it's covered in chocolate, they have to make it palatable, or you'll never buy it. So because of that, they're gonna have more sugar, they're gonna put some things in there, it's more processed, that don't make it the most ideal food. That's why we only allow you one a day. So, but basically to make things simple, and you might correct me if I'm wrong, basically said, for the grab and go, we don't need you to like try to figure out and cut the bar in half, you can just have a protein bar. Now, some are definitely better than others. And she lists a few here that you may be able to find around here or not. The one we like to use here is called a Builder's Bar, Cliff Builder's Bar. It's got about 20 grams of protein, and it's a little bit higher in sugar maybe than some other ones that you can find, but it's basically all pure ingredients, so we really like it for that reason. Okay? But there's other ones listed here by all means. If you're not sure, bring in or take it. If you're tech savvy, yeah, you can bring one in, you can take a picture of it, let me see the nutrition label, and send it to us. And then, what about this one? That's a common question to get all the time. What about this protein bar? What about that protein bar? Send it in, bring it in, take a picture, email it to us, and we'll give you our feedback. If we don't like it, we'll tell you another one. Maybe that's a little bit better choice for you. Okay? But go ahead, I'm sure you would say to you, you can eat the whole thing. Okay?
Yeah, so you'll see at the bottom here, because we asked about this, it says, so let's look under like a 3-unit portion, it says, 2.1 ounces of Cliff Builder Bar, which is like the difference is like 50 calories. Just tell people one that you can have, anybody, regardless of a unit portion, can have one Cliff Builder Bar as a meal. So you're fine with it. Don't worry about splitting it in half and doing it. It's not going to make a big difference. That particular example is not going to make a big difference at the end of it.
Right.
And I would say my argument is we literally carry one protein bar and one protein butter because we think they're the best on the market. We carry the Builder Bar before this program, so I'm glad it was on there. We carry them. They're really good. You can find them in other places, but they're really good. And the protein powder that we carry, we believe, is the best on the market. It doesn't have any aspartame. It's high in good protein, and it's super low in carbs. So if you don't want to think about it, just get those. It's that simple. Obviously, we'd love it if you got it from us. You don't have to do the places you can get it from. Those are the two that just work really, really, really well. A lot of the brand names on, some of the other brand names we can't get here at the street. So if you're trying to find some of these things, you won't be able to find them all. They're US brands. So unless you go to the States, some people can shop in the States.
Yep.
But we have no problem finding you similar options. Maybe now's a good time to actually be able to.
Yep. Okay.
So what you're going to find on here some of the smoothies, they like to use this Dannon. It's called Light and Healthy here. Right hand side, second white page. Greek cherry yogurt. Okay. It's a great product, it really is. You can't get it here on
the nutritional value.
So the main thing about the yogurt is, a big issue people have, because a lot of people consider yogurt a healthy food for a lot of reasons, mostly because they market it as a healthy food, but just like a protein bar, they need to make it taste really good so you'll buy more, yet you think you're eating really healthy. Some of these yogurts have an insane amount of sugar in them, and are tend to be lower in protein. And remember, what I'm always saying, that's always the issue. Much sugar in carbs, not enough protein. Like, well, I'm eating yogurt, it's healthy. Yeah, there's like 30 grams of sugar in this and 2 grams of protein. It's almost like junk food, right? So in this case, we're trying to find Greek yogurt. Why Greek yogurt is all the rage right now? It's much higher in protein, right? Now, that it's higher in protein is pretty much across the board for Greek yogurt. But now the thing is, Greek yogurt, sometimes it's tart, people don't like that, so they start adding sugar to it. Right? So there's like key lime Greek yogurt, there's cherry Greek yogurt, there's all different kinds. But you gotta watch them because they start adding tons of sugar to it. One of the most deceiving ones is vanilla Greek yogurt. Vanilla Greek yogurt has the most sugar in it than the cherry, than the key lime. It's got the most, right? So there's a couple that we looked at online, that I looked at online, that are very close to the one that's on here in that. It's a little bit lower in sugar, that's a little bit higher in protein. The one you're gonna find most commonly is this Liberté one. Okay, Yeah, you can get it anywhere, you can get it at Zares, pretty much everyone has it. But as I'm looking through the food labels on each one, I'm looking, they're very different, they range in carbs. So the best ones that I found are, first of all, plain Greek yogurt, number one, all the time. It's got a ton of protein and not a ton of carbs. There's a coconut one, if you like coconut. That's very similar to the Dannon one. And then the third one is the strawberry one. That tends to keep the numbers relatively close. It's off by a few calories, but that's not going to make or break you.
And your comparison, sorry, but this is what your comparison is. So in the one that she mentions, you want to get something close to this. This is 80 calories, 12 grams of protein.
Right.
Real simple. There are lots of options out there to get close to that.
The one you find might be 100 calories. That's only a 20 calorie difference. That's very small. But the protein will still be high in there. So if you find one that's like 100 or 120 calories, that's okay. Just make sure the protein is up around 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, somewhere in there. And the carbs are below, let's say, 15, 12, somewhere down there. Because you'll look at something and you'll be like, 30 grams of carbs, oh my God, right? You don't learn to read food labels a little bit. Okay? The ones I said, the ones that I looked at are close. But feel free to go online and compare to the sheet that we have at the nutrition label. And just keep it close. You can go online and look up Dannon Greek cherry yogurt. It'll pull up the nutrition label and you just compare. Keep it close.
Okay. The yogurt that I had for lunch today from Costco, they're selling these nice big bags and big containers. And it's got the yogurt on one side and then their little mixture on the other side, if you've seen those. 12 grams of protein, 30 grams of carbs, 160 calories.
Okay. So way more than what that's on here.
Yeah.
And
it's thick. It's really sweet. So those are the big ones there, okay, in terms of things to be thinking of. I'm going to touch on some of the issues that came up last time. This common question is, almost everybody on this program is going to be eating more protein than they're accustomed to, and that is a good thing and not a bad thing. The only people that we're aware of that need to be concerned about increasing their protein, and again, it's got to be normally even beyond these levels, but if you have a compromised kidney function, you need to check it out with your doctor, black and white. Check it out with your doctor, and if they say yay or nay, then we got to react to that. It's that simple. Nobody else has any concerns. The research is totally 100% clear. We could, and I'm not suggesting you do this, we could triple the protein for every single person on here in this, and it is still extremely safe. I'm not suggesting you need to do that. We're not going to do that. But it's a lot more protein than you're taking in. And the point of that is protein, the great thing about protein is it makes you feel full. Okay? Full for a longer period of time. Some of the negatives initially are that it might give you an upset stomach, might give you constipation, might give you gas. Okay? If you or general bloating. If you find those things are happening, the best solution, pharmacy, over the counter, ask for a digestive enzyme, it will clear it up like right away. Okay, and a digestive enzyme is something you just eat with your meals. And it's something that's natural occurring in our body. And you just ask your pharmacist, they'll suggest a good digestive enzyme, and you're all set. Literally, I've taken them for a long time, but when it started initially, she's like, Karen said, Mom, Mike, don't you remember? I thought, like, the two people that we had problems with, I took them and said, cleared up next day, no problem. And it was bloating and constipation were the two. It was only two or three people, but automatic. So just be prepared for that for some of you. Okay, that was a big one. The program has, actually, what do you think the dropout rate in the program is? We're going to have, I think we're at 38 or 40. We're at 38. What do you think the dropout rate is for the program? How many people will not finish the program? What percent? What do you think?
Half.
Oh my gosh. I wouldn't run the program. I seriously wouldn't run it. I don't care. I wouldn't run it.
20%.
Okay? So about 7 or 8 of you will not finish the program. For all kinds of different reasons, most of them not great reasons, but I'm not going to judge you based on those reasons, so remember that if you drop it, I don't think any less of you. But it's a big change. Sterility is totally realistic, it's something you should be able to keep doing, but people let shit get in their head and they get overwhelmed, as opposed to, hey, I'm struggling here, I'm dying, I'm really feeling, call us, email us, let's meet, we'll talk to you, we can bring it down and calm you down. It's not the end of the world, but if you just try and give up and do it on your own, it's not gonna do it. So really try and fight through that. Some of the issues, so definitely in the first couple weeks, some people struggled with that. Some people by the third or fourth week were getting our, and we're gonna send out emails to prepare you for these things ahead of time. By the third or fourth week, some people were like, oh my gosh, I have all these recipe choices now, I feel wrong. If you're feeling overwhelmed by the third or fourth week, the response is really simple. Go back to week one. Repeat the week one recipes. The week one recipes are the simplest. She sets it up that way. They're the easiest ones to do. You've already done them. So just go back to that if you're feeling that way. And as we're giving you new recipes each week, if you've got some from week one that you want to repeat, keep using them. There's nothing wrong with that. We encourage you to try the new recipes, but you can definitely repeat the ones from the first week, 100%. Okay? That's really important. So just ask if you're struggling. You've got to ask. We want everybody to be successful, but the reality is not a reality.
And so, another reality is that nobody here, I would bet, there's probably not one of you that's going to eat every single meal exactly perfectly how it was. I don't think we had that. Maybe we're pretty damn close.
Yep.
That's the goal. You're trying to, the closer you stick to the program, obviously the better results you're going to get. But if you screw up one day and you eat a Big Mac, okay, it's not, program's not over for you.
That's really messed up.
Oh, and I want to be careful. I want to be careful how I say this and about the impression that I give you, because I don't want you to think that you can take a week off and it's going to be fine. Right? That's totally going to pretty much eliminate any chance of winning the competition, but it doesn't mean you can't still get results. In other words, we had people last time around that they fully admitted they screwed up for a whole week, but some of them still lost like 10, 12 pounds, a couple of them, 7, 8, without, you know what I mean? Now, I don't want you to do that, of course, we want you to follow the program as close as you can, but the point is, and we're going to bring it up, is because if you screw up one day or one meal, it's okay, just get back to it. Don't start beating yourself up and thinking, oh God, I quit, it's over, because you might think that sounds silly now, but watch this, watch what goes on in your head when you do it, right? You can have that thought. It's okay, just get back on the program. So maybe now, because you screwed up that one meal, you're gonna lose 19 and a half pounds instead of 20. So what, right? Keep going. Okay?
You will get the same amount of support from us whether you mess up or not. That's it. We're not gonna give up on you, we're not gonna give you any less support. Don't be friggin' whining to us if you're not seeing results, if you're not following the damn program. It's that simple. It's like, you messed up, okay, here's what we gotta do. Let's get back on track. If we gotta give you a pep talk, we'll give you a pep talk. If we gotta give you a kick in the butt, we'll give you a kick in the butt, whatever it takes. But we're still gonna support you. But don't come whining to us if you're messing up and not following the program. You gotta follow the program. It's that simple, and not your own version of the program.
Is this a no alcohol program?
It's funny, I just put that down there. This is just for me. Good luck with that. It was for me. That didn't work that good. Oh, amazingly.
There's no sheet on that?
Amazingly.
Was it?
There's no alcohol on this program. Oh. I'm not familiar with a lot of weight loss programs that have alcohol listed in the menus.
Okay, but you
know, it's just
obviously being very sarcastic. No, but I was going to bring it up before you said it.
No wine.
I was going to bring it up. Can you, can you have some? Sure you can. Don't put wine into me if you're not seeing the results of that. It's that simple. It really is. Some people, and everybody's taking different, everyone's like, everyone takes different perspectives. They'll be like, I want 15 pounds. Whatever I got to do, I will lose it. Then don't take any alcohol. You're like, you know, I'm going to be okay losing 2-3 pounds a week. I'm going to be okay. I'm going to do this for a long time. Totally different attitude. That's fine. Then again, then let's just be on the same. Don't fool us. Don't come to me all frustrated and pissed off and say, you told me we're going to lose this weight. Just be honest with us. You had some wine or you did this or that. It's fine. Let's get back on track. Here's what you can do this week to make up for it. Okay? So we have 10 minutes left. I want to touch on a couple of things. Kind of expectations here. Week one is by far the best week for most people. Most people. Okay? You're going to see anywhere from, and anytime I say this, there's going to be some person that doesn't lose this amount of weight in the first week, and you're going to feel like a loser. You're not. It's not a big deal. You're fine. Okay? It's not, we didn't center you out. This isn't another plan that didn't work for you. Trust the process. It works. But the first week is normally the biggest week. 4 to 10 pounds is the average in the first week. The second week is a big downer. Sometimes people stay level and then lose 1 or 2 pounds. Totally expected. We'll send an email out to tell you that. Weeks 3 and 4, you go back to that 2 to 4 pounds normally. Again, there are people who lost more. Last program, our top 2 people lost 26 pounds each. So again, those were our top 2. We had over 10 people that lost 12 to 20 pounds. So there were lots of people that saw really good results. So that, in terms of kind of the weight loss and expectations, that's kind of where you're going to be along that kind of spectrum. Okay. I want you to go to this. It's on the right hand folder, right towards the back. Click down this. TakeDown challenge week 1, 11 units. This is an example of the sheet we're going to send you that's going to lay out your portions. And for a couple of females. Do we have any really short men here? No, I'm not going to pick you out if you are, but you're exercising too much. You wouldn't fall in this category anyways, and you're not really short. But you exercise more than the average person, so you wouldn't fall in this. So let's say one of the females, again, this is the exact sheet that we'll be sending to you tomorrow. The only difference is going to be you're going to have different numbers along the left-hand side. It's going to be individualized to you. This is exactly what the sheet will look like. Every week, you're going to get a new sheet like this sent out to you. The numbers on the left-hand side are going to be the same because they don't change. Your portions do not change week to week. The recipes that are listed in here all correspond to the yellow booklet. Okay? It's that simple. So, for example, if we look at breakfast. This is week 1. Everything on here corresponds to the yellow recipe booklet that you've got in your folder. It says, enjoy a 3-unit portion of recipe A. That was the smoothie. Yep. Yeah. Enjoy a 3-unit. It's pretty simple. 3-unit portion. Now, you may say, why else should you write this down? It just works for her. I'm not going to question her. She's been doing this for a long time. It works. So all of these are just laying some things out for you a little bit more. Honestly, our take was, I think this is a little bit confusing, but the reality is, Carolyn's run this for 8 years. She knows what the hell she's doing. It's worked well. So
there would be no difference between you writing this 3 on this meal 1 option, this meal 3 on this meal 2 option, right. Number 2 on the 3 option. Number 3, right? It's just take those numbers and go down each meal. It's the same thing. It's just written a different way.
Yeah. So if this confuses you, forget about it. Just know these unit portions along the line.
You'll be fine.
It's that simple.
Yeah.
But just ask us. Yes. Yep.
You can have coffee.
A lot of coffee. If you have milk, it's got to be, it's gonna count. It's fine. It's going to count. That counts. Coffee is not going to count.
Have milk, you can have coffee, you can have green tea, you can have as much water as you want, and you can have, she allows diet pop, just, please, like,
there's an article in here about,
yeah, there's a sheet that has of it.
Okay. One diet pop a day is not going to prevent you from seeing great results.
Right.
On this week,
we
have
some problems, right?
So this sheet you'll get from us every week, we'll send it to you by email, the girls will send it out tomorrow to you, okay? But essentially, all you need from us are these numbers along the left-hand side. All these meals you've already got. The rest of you know, okay.
Yeah.
The
way you determine the portion size and the numbers is strictly based on
top secret. She doesn't tell me.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I mean, I honestly couldn't even answer it. But go ahead. I'll ask the question. Like, our, she figures it out, literally.
Oh, it's not you guys that are no. figuring
it out? There's a program. Well, wow, I mean,
I can tell you, we can, yeah, we know what's basically.
We do it every day in here with our one-on-one clients, figure it out, right? But she's got her own system here for these foods. She knows these recipes and exactly how many grams of what's in it. She's done all that.
No, I mean the fact that you're going to tell me I'm a 3, 3, 4.
Right.
That's going to be based on my measurements and my
your
weight.
Measurements, your age, your gender, your current amount that you're exercising, your current amount you're eating. All those questions I asked you when you sat down, guys, when we did your measurements, that's what those unit portions are based on. That's why we had to do it ahead of time. Yeah.
And this is my second question is, if you do any yoga, Pilates, that, is that considered strength training?
Cardio. Mm-hmm. Your heart rate has to get up in order for it to be considered cardio. That's stretching the key.
So
unless you're doing a power yoga or something else where your heart rate's coming up, it's nice, it's good, there's lots of benefits, it's not cardio, it's not strength training. Do it.
Yeah.
It doesn't count. It's extra.
For something.
I know.
It's great.
Just
right. Yes, Bob.
Just your weight loss goal. People have
okay, those are the two winners, right? We didn't promote that. I'm not at all saying everyone's going
to
win.
You have to look at some negative numbers in the sense of why you have to find weight.
Yes, the top. So anyone that would have lost, let's say, between 15 and the winner's 26 pounds, that represents somewhere between a 7 or 8% all the way up to a 12 to 13% loss. The winner of this program is going to lose somewhere between 10 and 15% of their original body weight. Probably closer to 12, 13, maybe even pushing 14. That's a lot. That's a ton.
More sensitive.
Yeah, that's fine. Your numbers got it. There you go.
You got some big boys on the program. Well, those are the ones who are said again. I hope most of you guys are doing this for you, right? Obviously, winning it would be great. We'd love it if you won it, but the more weight you're carrying, two things with that. It doesn't guarantee you're going to win it because the more weight you're carrying, obviously, you've built up some habits to get there. It doesn't guarantee it's going to be easy. But guys that are carrying a lot more weight, you burn more calories. There's a higher chance. But it was a male and female that lost 26 pounds last time, so
yeah, I think that's what it is. And the guy who won wasn't the biggest guy.
No,
he was not.
Was it a male and female that win? Like it's one woman and one man?
No, they both lost 26 pounds, but the male was lighter when he started. So because he was lighter, he lost more of a percentage.
Right? But we don't do a male and female.
No, that's what I meant. Yeah.
But we're doing like a, this time we're doing like a first, second, and third place winner, and there's going to be weekly winners. We're doing one. Possibly have more people sign up. It's good. It's a percentage. There will be a chart on the wall with your first name only, not your last name. We will not have your starting weight. You'll have your phone number, you'll have your address or anything, your first name only, and it will say week 1, week 2, week 3, and week 4. And it's going to say minus this, for some of you it'll say plus. It's going to say what you did, what you
but
lost.
But percentage only, not numbers.
We're going to be putting on the chart for all of our clients to see, and for us to have a visual, is the weight you lost that week. Some of you guys are going to actually gain some weight at some point on this program. That's not the goal. But you're going to do that because you're going to mess up. It happens. Between now and Sunday, if you decide to go on a crazy binge, your first week's weigh-in probably isn't going to be that great.
We had that
please
happen.
Let us know that. Don't come back all pissed off saying, oh my gosh, I only lost a pound. Well, you actually gained 5 pounds.
You gained 6 pounds on the weekend. You lost 7 pounds.
We had someone come in that didn't tell us that until the second week. Well, actually, I didn't.
Yeah, and we're pulling our hair out. It's never us.
Yeah.
Just doing this a long time, 6 years weight loss, it's never me. It's always
I won't even say, don't take it the wrong way. It totally is. We've heard every story under the sun. It's like you're not, and if you are unique, go to the doctor, get your metabolism checked, send me the report. You're normal. Sorry. You can have a compromised thyroid function, you can have a lot. It doesn't mean you should be gaining weight on a weight loss program. It certainly doesn't mean you should only be losing 1 pound a week. If you're slower, that's fine.
I've trained at least 30 or 40 people that takes input. Half slow, as long as not, they all lose weight. So, you have to work a little harder than maybe someone who doesn't have that? Absolutely, but it doesn't mean it's impossible. And it's actually not that much better. Just follow up.
Sunday nights, one service, I'm going to forget.
I took it right now.
Sunday nights, Wednesday and Thursday nights. Meet up a couple nights to prepare to just get some work done on these meals. If you do it, the rest of your week is going to be so smooth. I don't suggest you come home every night and make a meal. Make them in batches. Get a few things ahead.
get your lunches, get your dinners, pack them in Tupperware containers. She has some suggestions for that kind of stuff. Just get it done. Sundays at my place normally, I'm cooking 4 or 5 meals for the rest of the week. Our fridge is set. Is that something? Most weeks, not perfect. Tuesday.
September 10th is Tuesday. We did that for a couple reasons. We got Thanksgiving coming up on a Monday, so we're going to be able to win that day, or weigh in that day. So it just made more sense, given this next 28 days, to do it, to start it on a Tuesday.
You don't have that day. You don't have one. You don't have that. I like that question. I'll tell you what. I like that question, because you give me a month or a time of year where you're not going to have some major function in that month. Summer. Every month, every week, there's something. Right? It's not Thanksgiving, it's Christmas, it's Easter, it's whatever.
So
Mark, we're gonna wrap it up.
Yeah, we're gonna wrap it up.
You know how on the, like, say on the grocery list, it shows a question mark and a K.
Yes.
So, does that mean it says at the bottom in the little key
option.
There, it's an option, like choice of product. So what does that mean exactly?
Well, you got shallot. So under produce, if you look 5 down, it's not a specific type of shallot.
Okay.
You can choose.
So Remark has 5, I can choose any one I want.
Oh, yeah, I'm not worried about what kind of shallot. Well, there's going to be a variety of shallots you can choose from.
Right. Or an onion. There's an onion on here, too. So I can choose any type of onion.
Apples.
Okay.
If you have to go, you go. If everyone wants to stay, we'll stick around and answer questions. We do have a bunch of other people we need to measure up. So.
That's the main thing. So tomorrow you're gonna get an email from us. Sheet's gonna look just like this. The only thing is, along the left hand side, you're gonna have different numbers. That is it. Nothing stopping you from going out. If you're really ready for rock and roll, you want to go out tonight and get your groceries and go for it. The program starts on Tuesday. You want to get a head start? Get started. You get started right away. It's up to you. There will be some people that will probably get started over the next couple days. So that's what's going to happen tomorrow. Tuesday, the program officially starts. Get your workouts in. All those things that we talked about. If you're not sure, you got to ask us. Then a week from Tuesday, the 17th, will be your first weigh-in. You'll stop at the front desk and just say, I'm here for my weigh-in. And if Mark and I are available, we'll come up. If we're not, then the girls will do it. Every Saturday, starting this Saturday, we're including a group workout. 11 o'clock here, it's included with the program. There's no extra cost.
Literally,
11
right
o'clock
here.
In this room. Okay?
Every Saturday.
11 o'clock right here. So it'll be
the
center.
It doesn't start until 2
seconds. No. But starting this Saturday.
Oh, sorry. Yes.
Starting this Saturday. Last time we started it, the first Saturday, let's get you going.
All right. Fine.
There's no when you say a meeting, there's no way,
yeah.
Right? No.
Right.
There's a meeting if you feel the need for us to meet. There's nothing scheduled, you don't need to come in for a weigh-in or anything this weekend.
Could you start drafting
anything
on the Tuesday?
Yeah. If you want to start anything, you don't need to see your journals for these days.
You're not show up. You can show up, we're gonna say, it's great to see you here for your workout. Someone's gonna do it.
We're gonna have someone to hug. Don't worry.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, if you gotta go, great. I mean,
thank
it was nice to have
guys. Oh, one last thing. There's some sheets in here we did not cover. If there's questions you have, pretty much guaranteed the answer is in here. But it's okay. Still feel free to ask us whatever. But there's still sheets in here we didn't cover. But you know, children, things like that. Lots of information. Really encourage you to read it. Okay.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.